Where I work is the Northern Cape. It's in a rural community. Most of our clients travel about 300 k's to the hospital.
We encounter a lot of problems during pregnancy, after pregnancy, that entails postpartum hemorrhages.
PPH has caused a lot of death, maternal death. The babies, they grew up without mothers.
We realized that we need a uterine balloon to tamponade the uterus to reduce blood loss, either for the purpose of referring patients or for the purpose of managing the patient in a hospital with all the necessary equipment.
Sanapi was approached to develop a low-cost UBT device specifically for low-resource settings. The device is basically used to close off a wound where the placenta has been attached to the uterus. If bleeding continues, the patient suffers the risk of bleeding to death. The device is designed to optimally close off the wound without pressing too hard. Keeping pressure on a wound will normally have the effect of sealing the bleeding.
There were two important groups of devices: the commercially available devices, which are generally very expensive, and then what we can call the makeshift devices that you can actually manufacture yourself by using a condom or using a surgical glove. Taking the unique features of the surgical glove balloon and putting this into a commercially available unit was the way to go.
The major difference of our product is firstly the designed in cost. So we designed it to be really a low cost product with high quality materials.
You don't need to spend tens of millions of dollars to innovate. Something simple and effective can really, really work, particularly in low resource settings.
The device will have a huge impact because I think it could easily be made available at different levels of healthcare, like primary healthcare, which is the midwife obstetric units, district hospitals, regional hospitals, as well as a central hospital. And it will certainly have an impact when patients do develop this severe complication.
Countries that could not afford this technology can now afford it. Many families that may have gone without a mother will now actually have a mother to look after and care for that family.
Research and development in lesser resource settings remains very, very important because that's where the problems are, that's where the complications occur, and that's where we need the solution.
In order to be able to do that R&D, you obviously need resources, and one of the most important things is people and talent. In order to retain that talent, we need R&D investment. When you do that, you start building an R&D community, and your speed of developing solutions will become quicker.